Recently, I printed this Imperial Shuttle kit card by using a free STL file. But there was one small issue. It was way too small. So I wanted to see how much bigger I could make it by using the same file. Hey everyone, Danny here with Vader Dad Builds. This right here is the latest print that I've done. It's a Lambda-class Imperial Shuttle kit card. This one was a lot of fun to put together, and here's the final model right here. This one will probably end up on my Christmas tree this year. As much as I like the final model, there was only one small issue. It was a bit too small. I think it needs to be at least
3 times bigger than this.
He's absolutely right.
All right, so let's go through the build and review of the original file, and then let's see how big we can make it. Printing this file was super easy. No need for supports or any other modifications, so I give it a 10 out of 10 for 3D printing. Now it's time to put the model together. Each of the parts are labeled with a letter. I will use these letters to reference the parts in this assembly. You can just twist off the parts easily, but I decided to use these cutters to give them a cleaner break. I wanted to use a really light gray filament for this build, but I only had white and gray to choose from. I decided on using the gray because I figured it would be okay if the shuttle ended up on the dark side. First step is to slide the sides of the cockpit, which are parts F and H, into the main body, part D. Now I clip out part G. Then I slide it into the top here. This forms the nose and cockpit. Next, I'm clipping out parts I and J. I slide part I into the front. I need to add the dorsal stabilizer wing next, so I clip out part A. I will also need the top of the shuttle, which is part E. I attach the top to the stabilizer wing and then slide it on right here. And now I attach the back of the ship, which is part J. The tabs that hold it on here are pretty tight, and there's not much flexibility in PLA, so I'm trying very carefully to push it on without breaking it. The last parts are the two flanking wings, parts B and C. There's the first one, and now I need to remove the second one from the frame and attach that one as well. The wings were a little loose after attaching them, so I applied some glue to hold them in place. All the other parts held together well without glue. I give the assembly a 9 out of 10. Really, the only issue was needing glue for the wings, but overall, it was fun to put together. And here's the finished piece. For the final build, I give it a 7 out of 10. I like it, but as you know, I think it's pretty small. Another nice part about this model is that the creator, Fix'em Dude, provided a version with the parts without the frame. All I needed to do was to use mesh mixer to separate the pieces into separate STLs. Then I took the biggest part and increased the size to fit on my 3D printer. Just make sure that you increase all three dimensions equally. If you're using Cura like I am, then you'll do this by making sure that uniform scaling is checked. I was able to increase it by 350%. Then I increased the size of all the other parts by 350% as well. And here we go, printing again. I have to say I was more excited than I expected to be when I saw how big the printed parts were compared to the original. Overall, I'm using 482 grams of filament when the original was only 28 grams. Also, the printing time was 57 hours instead of the 4.5 hours from the original. And now let me show you just how much bigger the new parts are. Alright, it's time to assemble the large shuttle. It's pretty much the same process except the parts are already separated and it's now a much larger scale. Something I didn't think about when I scaled everything up was that the gaps where the pieces slide in are now bigger as well. I'm about halfway done with the assembly now, just attaching the dorsal wing and the top. Again, the back is pretty tight, but I'm able to snap it on. Since the parts did not fit together as tightly, I will need to glue them together. I'm just going to add some glue to all the areas where the parts connect. The glue I always like to use for connecting 3D printed parts is a super glue gel. I'm curious about what other types of glues people like to use, so let me know in the comments. And now the last two parts. I'm gluing the two flanking wings to finish everything up. And now I'm gluing and attaching the last wing. Alright, so here's the original model. And the larger one at 3.5 times the size. I'm definitely happy with that one now. If you want to see more videos like this, please hit the subscribe and notification buttons. Thank you for watching.